Good morning. The time has come for us to start our service on this morning. I'm going to ask that you read to stand for the reading of God's word on this morning. This morning we'll be coming from Psalm 91. Psalm 91. Good news. It is good news. I ain't going to bring you no bad news today. I got some good news for you here. Psalm 91, and it reads thus. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. Then they shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet, because He had set His love upon me. Therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. That word is blessed on this morning.
Let us bow our heads. Our Father, our God, again we come to say thank you, Father God, for another week. Father God, we thank you, Lord, that we still have a breath in our bodies. We still have blood running warm in our veins. And Father God, we say thank you. If it had not been for you, Lord, I don't know where we would be today. But we thank you, Lord, that we have a portion of strength, a portion of health and strength today. And Father God, we understand, Lord, if it had not been for you, we would not have been here today. Thank you, Father God, for those homes we left and those cars we come down the highway with. Thank you, Father God, for that food on the table this past week. Thank you, Lord, for all the provisions, Lord, you've given us throughout this week. Father God, we thank you, Lord, because it had not been for you, we would not have made that. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Father God, for your love and your tender mercy and your kindness, Father God, that keeps shining down on us. Father God, down through the years, Lord, you have provided for us, Lord, and we want to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for this house, Father God, that we're presiding in right now, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the bishop, first lady, first family. Continue, Lord, to bless, Lord, the bishop and the first family. Continue, Lord, to strengthen the first lady. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now look on, Father God, those that are incarcerated, those that are in the homes today, those in the hospital rooms, Father God, we ask, Lord, you share your love among them also. Bless, Lord, Father God, our unsaved family members right now. We pray, Father God, that you bring them in before it's everlasting too late. Yes, Lord, we pray that you bring them in before it's everlasting too late. Save them, Lord. That you have done for us. Father God, again, we ask that you just look on us today. Bless, Lord, every church door that is open in your name. Bless, Father God, those that are not here in absence, but bless, Lord, those that have a desire to come, to press their way to the house of prayer. Strengthen them today. Give them, Lord, the desires of their heart. Father God, bless our mothers today. Bless our senior deacons today. Bless, Lord, the missionaries today of this church. In Jesus' mighty name, look on the ministers. those that are in absence, Father God, are serving somewhere else. Father God, we ask, Lord, you strengthen them now and give them that blessed word today to give to your people. And Father God, again, we say thank you. Hallelujah. We say thank you. Now, Lord, we thank you for your grace and your mercy that you're shadowing on this day. And we claim it done now in Jesus' mighty name. Thank God. Thank God. Amen.
Somebody. Hallelujah. God is worthy. You guys excited to be in the house this morning? Oh, come on. We can do better than that. Are you excited to be in God's house this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you.
let us continue to praise this and worship our Lord. Just keep on worshiping. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. I don't have to find it. It's running after me. I don't have to look for it. It's running after me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yes, God. Yeah. Your goodness. Your goodness. Yes, God. That's not AC. That's the presence of the Lord. That's not AC. That's the presence of the Lord. And when he is in the room, let us acknowledge him. When he is in the room, let us acknowledge him. So, Lord, we thank you for being here today. God, we thank you for being here today. It's because of you that change happens. It's because of you that healing happens. It's because of you. That the grace of God, his peace, his love, his mercy, his joy, everything that is him, it is because of him. And that's why we can say, hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Hallelujah. As a matter of fact, if you could just look to your neighbor, we ain't done that in a while, but look to your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, it is a setup. Now you don't know why you said that. And it's okay, I'm gonna tell you in a second. So look to somebody else and tell them, neighbor, it is a setup. Now, here is the reason why. Because the thing is this. Sometimes you declare things that you didn't realize you were declaring. Sometimes the bishop or one of the preachers might say something and tell you to say something. And you say it not understanding that's a declaration. So there are times that somebody might say, tell your neighbor that I am healed, or tell your neighbor that you are healed. Tell your neighbor that you are this or you are that. And you might say it not realizing that you needed it. So there are times that you will end up saying, I am healed, not realizing that you needed to hear that. Because not realizing that you didn't understand it, there may not have been something physical, but there may have been something mental that was going on. And you realize that now that I've said I'm healed, I've been touched, I've been delivered, I've been set free. Did you know that you were saying that? And here is the thing. This is why it's important to come to church. You can be seated if you want to, but this is why it's important to come, because it is the scripture that says, fail not to assemble yourselves, right? And so the thing is, if I'm telling you, and I'm in the seat beside you, that means that sometimes the miracle that you needed is coming from the person, not up here, but from the person beside you. And so that's why it's important that when the man or the woman of God is saying for you to say something, that you hear what they're saying. And so say this to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, free. You are today His. Now here's the thing. It's one thing to say it, but it's another thing to receive it. So if you have said, I'm healed, I'm saved, I'm free, if you receive that, on the count of three, just yell, I receive it. One, okay, y'all ready? Again. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor,
you are
healed. Now say, I receive that. Say, neighbor,
you are
saved. And say, I receive that. Say, neighbor,
you
have been changed. And say, I receive that. Now, if you do, give God a praise right now. Hallelujah, God. God, we thank you. We receive that in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Change, heal,
I'm free
from sin.
To God. Amen. Amen. Why don't you stand up one more time just for a minute. Just stand up one more time. Amen. Go ahead and let it go. Give God the praise. I believe we just need to take a couple steps. I want you to just begin to take a couple steps and walk out of it. Just walk out of it. God has restored. He's made new. He's healed. He's made free. Amen. Take another couple steps. I didn't see very many people take some steps. If you believe it, just take a couple steps. Just walking in that newness, walking in that change, walking in the new you. Receive that from the Lord. Receive that from the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. God's love. Amen. What I really like is no more condemnation, no more guilt, no more shame. Those are tricks of the enemy, trying to make you feel bad about, even now, I'm trying to speak lies into your mind. Just tell them right now, no more condemnation, no more shame. The Lord has made me free. Who the Lord has made free is free indeed. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give him a mighty shout. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. Amen. You can be seated. Unless you don't want to, if you just want to go ahead and praise Him. Hallelujah. Amen. I just want to welcome you here this morning, each and every person. I think we do have some visitors, guests this morning. And we just want to welcome everyone, especially you. Who is you? You are you. Amen. We're so thankful that each person is here this morning. It's taken time to come out, Oak Grove Baptist Restoration Ministries, and contribute to the praise and to the worship and honoring the Lord. Amen. We certainly believe the scripture is true, that if God be lifted up, if He be lifted up, if He be lifted up, He will draw all men unto Him. Amen. And we want to be drawn. We want to be closer. He said, if we draw nigh to Him, He will draw nigh unto us. Amen. So I want to read a scripture to you this morning, 2 Corinthians 9, 6 through 8. It says this: each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. I'm not going to ask you to cheer. Just scripture says He loves a cheerful giver. You know if you're cheerful or not. Amen. God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able, I want you to listen to this part. God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things. He's able to bless you abundantly in all things. At all times. In all things, at all times, having all you need, you will abound in every good work. Amen. That's a blessing from the Lord. Amen. And that's our scripture today. I just want you to think on that as we prepare to give this morning. Not so much giving just to get. We're given to be a blessing. He says we don't have to be a borrower. And I don't want you to be a borrower. So I may be able to give something here that's going to help you over there, out there. So that's why we give, to give to be a blessing. We're going to pray over the offering. Father, it's in Jesus' name that we pray, and that we hear, and that we believe, because of all your abundant blessings, because you loved us first and allowed us to love you, that you've come into our hearts and changed not only our mind, you've changed our nature, you've changed our outlook, you've made our lives so much better. And so now we're at this point that we can contribute back. And Father, we're so thankful that you have blessed us to be able to give. We thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity. We ask for more opportunities to give in many different ways. But at this time, we're giving up our finances. And we thank you, God, for blessing our finances. And even more, we ask you to bless that person beside me and behind me, all around me, that you bless them. Just what your word said, you're able to meet them in all things at all times. We believe that, and we thank you for it. We ask your blessing over the offering in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay. Your baskets are going to be on the left side of your aisle. Just ask you to get a basket and deacons or gather your offering. Amen. Wasn't praise and worship awesome this morning? Did you feel the same tingles and chills and surges that I felt? Amen. I love when that happens. Amen. I'm asking, can that happen again? I mean, we like to, we love that. Amen. Amen. But I think we were doing something when that happened too, right? We were giving. Praise the Lord. I have just one announcement. This is a big announcement, so I'm going to make this announcement this morning. Okay. Is everything all right? All right. So I'm going to go ahead. I don't want to make the announcement while everybody's asking, moving and running, because I want you to hear this announcement. Okay, y'all ready for this announcement? Are you really ready for this announcement? Show me how ready you are for this announcement. All right. I wish y'all could see the picture. It's a beautiful picture on this announcement. Old Dominion University Commencement Ceremony 2023. Elena Jackson. All right. BS in Speech Language Pathology and Audiology. That's a lot even just to read. BS in Speech Language Pathology and Audiology from the Darden College of Education and Professional Studies. Let's go one more time. It's going to be on May the 6th at 9 a.m. I don't think all of us can go. They got limited capacity. It's just a thought. Maybe we could do something. But you can view via live stream. And I think we'll post announcements in the website somewhere. But it's www.odu.edu. And you can view this live stream. It'll be May 6th at 9 a.m. I believe Elena's mom is here. Woo! Would you stand up so we can just congratulate you? Amen. I know she's a proud mom. Amen. Amen. I believe we're going to have some special music now. And you've seen him before, but you hadn't seen him for a little while. And so we're very honored this morning. We have the Johnson family in the house. Oh, I thought he was going back to get Mrs. Johnson, Sister Johnson. Gonna have something new. Would you like to speak before he blesses us this morning?
Dreams defeating. Dreams defeating, clouds misleading, the future seems so grim, And now your ray of hope is growing dim. Broken promises, no second chances. The weight is much too great. Don't waste a moment, please. Don't hesitate to take your troubles to the one who can turn the tide around. No other refuge can be found. Only God can heal the pain and hurt you feel. Only God can heal the wounds that tear you apart. Only God can heal. There is no better place where you can go. Don't you know that? Only God can heal. Hearts unready, steps unsteady. You wanna take it slow. Somehow you feel that you just can't let go of past emotions, lasting notions. They say you can't be free, but there's a way to change your destiny. Oh, take your troubles to the one who can turn the tide around. No other refuge can be found. Only God can heal the pain and hurt you feel. Only God can heal the wounds that tear you apart. Only God can heal. There is no better place where you can go. Don't you know that only God can heal? He'll be there whenever you call him. Don't despair, the Lord is right there by your side. Anywhere, wherever you're falling, burdens bear, the Lord is right there by your side. 'Cause only God can heal the pain and hurt you feel. Only God can heal the wounds that tear you apart. Only God can heal. There is no better place where you can go. Don't you know that only God can heal the pain and hurt you feel? Only God can heal the wounds that tear you apart. Oh, yes, he can. There is no better place where you can go. Don't you know that only God can heal? Oh, yes, he can. Only God can heal. you were denied, then crucified. Yet you prayed to your Father to forgive us. We've caused you pain time and again. Yet you laid down your life because you loved us. I was guilty then. Here I am again. Against you only have I sinned. Change me now. Never let my heart grow cold. Change me somehow. Purify my needy soul. Will you look into my heart? Tell me what you see. Cleanse me when you find any wicked way in me. With your tender touch, Lord, I need you so much to change me now. The seeds I've sown, the deeds I've done, by the power of your blood, please remove them. Restore my joy. I need you, Lord. I need more of your love so you can use me. Will you search my heart with your holy light? Take every wrong and make it right. Lord, hear my cry. Please change me now. Never let my heart grow cold. Change me somehow. Purify my needy soul. Will you look into my heart? Tell me what you see. Cleanse me when you find any wicked way in me. This very hour, Lord, fill me with your power. I wanna be so close to you, Jesus, that nothing comes between us. With your tender touch, Lord, I need you so much to change me
for a few days, but thank you for praying for us and praying with us. continually the Lord just been good to us. So we are thankful and grateful to the hand of the Lord. Thank God for our youth going downstairs and others that are ministering today. Would you give God a great praise this morning? Amen. I just thank the Lord for all of you being here today on this Sunday morning. Praise the Lord. For the Mimes Ministry, thank you so much. Praise team, all the people of God, thank you so much for what you do to make the service what it is. All you contribute so greatly, so we just appreciate each of you. Well, if you have your Bibles, let's continue with the Word of God this morning. I'm in the book of John, chapter 20. The book of John, chapter 20. Praise the Lord. We're still working with Resurrection Month. Praise the Lord. John, chapter 20, beginning at perhaps verse 19. If you have it, say, I've got it. If somebody else said, no, wait just a couple more minutes, so I'll get there. But everybody got it. Praise the Lord. Thank you so very much. I'm in the book of John, chapter 20, beginning at verse 19. The scripture says, then the same day, at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the midst. Said to them, peace be with you. When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. So Jesus said to them again, peace to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you. When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Amen. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for this opportunity to share your word with the people of God today. Thank you, Lord. You're so good to us, Lord, and merciful unto us. We pray, oh God, for my sister, my brother that's standing with us right now. Praying, oh God, that your will be done in our lives. And Lord, we just give you thanks and give you praise and give you glory in all things today. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for health and for strength. We thank you, dear God, for allowing us to get up out of our bedside to move this way this morning. Somebody didn't make it. Somebody's life was cut off before time. But Lord, I just thank you, dear God, today that we're still here in the presence, in your presence today. We give you glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody shout amen. Amen. And amen. May be seated in the presence of the Lord. Praise God. Amen. Well, I know life is what it is, but you all just indulge with me just for a moment. Just give God the best praise you can give him. Just give God the best praise you can give him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank the Lord for all that he has done and still doing. Amen. I looked at that particular scripture this morning, throughout the week, and I'm thinking about that word, and if I had to put a title to it, it would just be like, when Jesus shows up. How many know it would be awesome when the Lord just shows up, and when he does show up, when God shows up, I guarantee it makes a difference in your life. I don't know about you and your life, but I know for myself that when the Lord shows up, things begin to change. Things begin to go in the right direction when the Lord really shows up. I know we're going through things and all that with the world, but I'm thankful when the Lord really shows up. And When I began to read that scripture, I thought about a song that one of the mothers of the church, Mother Charlotte Washington Green, used to sing and taught us how to sing, taught us that particular song. Very few of you probably remember her, but a couple of y'all in here knew her quite well, Mother Charlotte. And she taught us this song. She says, I remember singing this when I was in the junior choir. That was way back. I mean, a long time. Why y'all laughing at me? When I was in the junior choir, she taught us this song. The words were something like this. What a wonderful change in my life has been wrought since Jesus came into my heart. I have light in my soul for which long I have sought since Jesus came into my heart. Floods of joy, oh my soul, like a sea billows roll since Jesus came into my heart. Anybody remember that song? Well, good. Y'all good. Y'all with me. Praise the Lord. And I think about that to know that when the Lord really comes into your heart, your life got to change. Your life has to change. And we sung songs then because they taught us to sing them. And they told us to sing them, so we sung it because they told us to. But later on in life, you think about the words that you were singing. It makes a difference because when the Lord really comes in, it means something to you. It means something really special to you when the Lord really comes into your life. It floods your joy, oh my soul, just like sea billows roll when Jesus come into my heart. You have to be assured that when Jesus does come in, things will change for the good. When the Lord really comes into your life and shows up in your life, things will change for the good. I know the evil comes on every hand, but I thank God the change is going to come for your good. Amen. Be assured of that. Something has to happen. Something has to take place in your life when the Lord really comes in. Praise the Lord. Minister Mark was talking earlier, when the Lord comes in the room, something has to happen. Your life will drastically change, all for the good. For the good, your life will change. Praise the Lord. Something will happen. And we talked about this on Resurrection Sunday. We mentioned how the women got up early that morning. And they were up early going to the tomb to take care of Jesus there. And I asked the question, where were the men? But here it is. Verse 19 gives the answer to their question, because verse 19 says, then on the same day, which is resurrection morning, on the same day being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut and the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews. Fear caused them to hide out because they knew what they'd done to Jesus they could do to them. But I want to let somebody know today that's all right, because I know that wherever we are, if we need the Lord, he will be there just on time. Just in time. And somebody, songwriter say, may not come when you want to, but I guarantee you he will be right on time. Praise the Lord. And some commentators say that the doors were more than just being locked. They were probably barricaded, blocked up, because the enemy was coming after them. But don't be afraid, my brothers and sisters, when the Lord is for you, it's more than the whole world against you. When God is for you, you don't have to worry about what the enemy is trying to do to you. God is right there on your side. Amen. Praise the Lord. I know the doors were locked. I know that the doors were probably barricaded, but still God knows a way to show up just in time. I'm thanking God today that God knows how to show up at the right time, at the right season in my life. God knows how to show up. Tell somebody, God can show up in my life. He showed up already in my life. Praise God. I thank the Lord for that, to know that I can trust the God that's able to take care of me when I need his need the most. I'm thankful unto God today. I believe that he came into the room. He didn't have to open the door. He didn't have to turn the knob on the door handle. He didn't have to knock on the door, because John chapter 10, verse 9, he says, I am the door. He is the way. Praise the Lord. John 14 says unto him, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. No man come to the Father except by me. So the Lord is the door. He is the way. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He can make a way when there is no way at all. I want somebody just indulge me just to thank the Lord, for he is the way, he is the door. He can come in anytime he wants to. I open my door, praise God, he's knocking at the door. Let him into our lives today. He is so good and so gracious. God is so awesome. Songwriter said, never let a day go by without giving him thanks. Never let a day go by without giving him praise and giving him glory. Never let a day go by without giving God the praise and the thanksgiving that he so rightfully deserves. Praise the Lord. No need to worry. When you need him the most, he will show up. Hebrews 13:5, the B part of that says, for he himself, it says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. How confident does that make you today? How good does it make you feel to know that he will never leave you nor forsake you? Ain't that good news? I don't know about you, that's good news to me, that he will never leave me nor forsake me. Whatever I'm going with, whatever I'm dealing with, he will never leave me or forsake me. And so the Lord knew where they were. He didn't have to ask nobody. He knew where they were. He went to where they were. Guess what? He knows where you are. The Lord knows exactly where you are. He knows what you're going through. And if I look over this audience and scan it today, all of us are going through something different in our life. All of us have different situations we're dealing with. Praise the Lord. But guess what? He knows exactly where you are. He knows exactly what you're going through. He knows your obstacles right now in your life. Because he knows where you are, he can come right through the door. Praise God. He'll come right in this room. Don't have to open the door. He's just in right into his presence. Come on. And to know that God has shown up right in this room right now, you ought to praise him just like he's sitting beside you right now. You ought to give him praise, because he can come in a moment. Just welcome in the Holy Spirit that is right now in this place. Just welcome his presence, because he's ready to show up right on time just for you. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. And just to know, when he came in the room, the first thing he did, he said something to the people. He said something to the disciples. He said, peace be with you. Magical words. Great words. Peace be with you. Magical words. Great words. And they were in fear. They were totally in fear. But the word kept coming from Jesus, peace be with you. Watch this. And the Hebrew word for peace, it means shalom. And so when we say shalom, it really means harmony, wholeness, completeness, prosperity, welfare, and tranquility. That's a whole lot. But guess what? I need all of that. Tell you, I need all of that. I need all of that. Don't leave nothing out for me. I can use all of that. Anybody else can say you need that too? Am I by myself? I need all of that. I need all of that. I need a harmony, because things just work together when harmonized. Things just, y'all don't sing with, where are my singers at? Where are my praise singers? I know I got a few singers in here. How does it feel when you, Minister Liz, you know, see? But and that she done pretty good a few Sundays ago. She really did. She surprised me. She's done really well. But how do you know that, how do you know that when you sing and somebody harmonizes with you, it just makes it go good? Yeah. It just makes things. It makes things fit in the right pocket, like as opposed to, so I like that word, what it really means. It means harmony. It means wholeness. You're not just by yourself, but you're made whole now, and you just completed. That's what faith is, that's what peace is. and prosperity, not only dollars and money and cents, it just, God can make you prosperous in your life, prosperous in your walk with him, and then welfare and tranquility. I thank God for all of that. That's what peace really is. I thank God for the peace of God. I thank the Lord because Philippians says that the peace of God which surpasses all understanding will guard your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. The peace of God will guard your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. But I like what it says, because, and the peace of God which surpasses, not some, not a few, but surpasses what? All of your understanding, and guard your hearts and mind through Christ Jesus. I think that's real peace. That's real peace. Amen. So he was speaking that peace to the disciples. Prophet Isaiah says 9:6, for unto us a child is born, and a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders. His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. That's who he is. And that's what he is. He was then, and that's what he is right now. That's what he is in your life. That's what in my life. He is still the Prince of Peace. And at his birth, the angels shouted up words of praise, saying, glory to God in the highest, on earth peace, goodwill towards men. But now later on in the years, Jesus came up to the disciples in important words, saying again, peace be with you. Thank God he always gives peace in troublesome times. In trying times, he always knows how to give us peace. It was fear that brought the disciples together behind those locked doors. But after Jesus showed up the room, he gives them one thing that took away all of his fears away. That was peace be unto you. When you get closed up in your room, watch God. God's going to show up. When you block yourself away, get hiding away, get through all your burdens and trials and tribulations, watch the Lord. He's going to show up just in time. And you read that verse, it said it in verse 19, but you know what? He waited in verse 21, he said it again. Yeah. Which illustrates how important it is to remember the word of God. Yeah. Just because you heard it once don't mean you can't hear it again. Yeah. The more they heard it, the more they believed it. Because we know faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. In other words, the more they heard it, the more their faith began to give birth in their heart to the word of God. The more you hear the words, peace be with you, the more your heart begins to grow faith and to know that it is real, that God is right with you right now. His peace is with you. God's joy is with you. God's peace is with everyone in this room right now in this sanctuary. Amen. Let me go to the second point. I gotta let y'all go. Because the second point says that he breathes on them. Okay. Jesus breathed on them. He breathed on them. He breathed that. When he breathed, that was really the Holy Spirit coming. He breathed on them. Praise God. Lord, just breathe on me. God, just breathe on me. Just breathe. Whenever you get ready, just breathe on me. Because when he breathed on them, it's sort of like he had a calling on their life, because now he's ready to go back to be with the Father. But he said, I'm going to set you up. I'm going to breathe on you right where you are, boys. I know all of y'all are hanging up where you are. You're hiding up because you're afraid. But I'm going to breathe on you because you got a job to do. You got a work to do. God, just go ahead and breathe on me. Just breathe on me right where I am. I know I'm going through some stuff in my life right now. I don't know about you, but I'm going through some stuff in my life. I still thank God for breathing on me right where I am today. I thank God for breathing in my life right where I stand. Right in this sanctuary. It'd be an awesome thing when God, you hear that wind blowing. I know on the day of Pentecost, it was a wind blowing. God was just breathing all over those 120 people right there to receive the Holy Spirit. I know we got Pentecost coming in a few weeks from now, but in the meantime, I thank God for breathing on us right today. I thank God for filling the room with his breath right now in this house of worship.
I don't care what people said about you, where you were, where you are. It really don't matter. God, just breathe on me. God, just breathe on me today. God, just breathe on me. God, just breathe on me. God, just breathe on me. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. It was Adam there in Genesis when he was right there. Praise God. He had made him in his image, but he needed one more thing. He needed the breath of God to go inside of him to make him alive. When the Lord breathed inside of Adam, he became a living soul. So I thank God today when he breathed inside of us, we will become a new creature in Christ Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody bless the Lord one more time for me. He breathed on them. And when he breathed on them, they were made brand new. And it's just like when God did what he did, new life came in for the disciples. When God breathed, because Jesus and God, he's still the same. When he breathed on the disciples, they instantaneously became new creatures in Christ. You got to get the picture. The Lord is setting up. Minister Mark says it's a setup. And it is a setup because he was preparing them for the task that was at hand. Jesus had been with them for 3 years. Now, boys, you got to take care of this on your own. But I want you to do this on your own because I've already told you now that I've already given you peace. Yeah. I presented my peace to you, and now I breathed on you. Yeah. Praise God. Thank God for that. And you had to breathe on because that's new life coming to their life. And you know, you're testify to one more person in here that tell your neighbor that your new life is coming to you today too. Half of y'all didn't believe it. Half of y'all didn't believe it. Y'all just said what I said. Y'all didn't believe it. Y'all didn't believe that y'all got new life coming. Because when your Holy Spirit comes in your life, because that's what he done the next time, he breathed in the Holy Spirit to those guys. And I'm coming to tell you right now, when the Holy Spirit does come, you've got new life. You ought to tell somebody now, because I got the Holy Spirit coming, I have new life. That sounds a little bit better. About five of y'all said it, but you know, but when the Holy Spirit really comes, he will bring new life. You're not the same. I guarantee you that same enemy was chasing after you, but God is chasing after you with the Holy Spirit. You are a new creature in Christ Jesus. You are a new creature in Christ Jesus. Thank the Lord for being a new creature in Christ Jesus. The old man has passed away. All things now become new. Praise God. It don't mean the devil won't stop going after you. It don't mean the enemy will stop chasing after you. He will still keep chasing after you. But I am a new creature he's chasing now because the new man is inside of me. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. He breathed into my life. And then he's told him one thing. He said, just receive the Holy Spirit. How many of you like gifts? Okay, your birthday, how much you want a nice gift? How many Christmas time you want a nice gift? Praise God. Somebody say, every day I want a new gift. Something special every day, just, you know, you gave a watch 10 years ago, but it's time to get a new one now. Might want to buy a Rolex. Okay, let me go on. So he told them to receive the Holy Spirit. Praise God. He gave them peace. He breathed on them. Then he said, just receive the Holy Spirit. That's a gift. How many of you ready for your gift? Really ready for that gift. How many of you ready to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit in your life? Jesus said, receive it. Guys, just receive this. Praise God. He said, receive and breathe. The Holy Spirit is right there. Jesus breathed on the apostles, the Holy Spirit, showing that the Holy Spirit proceedeth as from the Father and so is also from him. Not only did Jesus speak peace or breathe the Holy Spirit upon them, he gave them authority to forgive. Okay? What does that mean, Pastor? It means, now, he said, as the Father sent me, I'm sending you. So what he was doing, he was setting them up to the place to know that God has something in line for them to do. There are souls still out here need to be saved. End times are coming. I heard somebody talk the other day. They said, end times not coming yet. Okay, that what you believe. I believe end times are coming. I believe that we are in the last days. I happen to believe that these floods, hurricanes, tornadoes, and shooting and killing for no reason at all, it lets us know that the Lord is soon to come back. It lets me know that time won't last its way always. We're just getting through right now because the time's going to come. One morning without even thinking about it, the sky will be lit up with the glory of the Lord. He's going to show back up to catch his church, take back your church without a spot or a wrinkle. And you have to be ready to receive him. And you need the Holy Spirit to be caught up in the presence of the Lord. Tell somebody, I need the Spirit of God in my life. I need to be baptized in the presence of the Lord. I need him to breathe on me right where I am, right in my seat. I need the Holy Spirit to breathe on me right now, right where I am. I need the Holy Spirit just to breathe on me. God, breathe on me. Breathe on me new life. Give me a new walk with God. I need a new walk with the Lord. Don't you dare be tricked by the enemy, because the person I heard this said he was on the radio telling the person, no, it's not the last days. But I come to tell you, I argue with him, not publicly, but I know for myself that end days are here right now. So much foolishness going on in this world. We need the Lord on our side. You ought to touch your neighbor on the shoulder. Don't hit them hard. Say, end time is coming. End time is coming. Don't hit them hard. That might be the sore arm. We're filing a suit against you. I can't pay those. Watch this. Before we can effectively deliver the message of salvation and forgiveness and the gospel of Jesus Christ, you need to have the Holy Spirit to do that effectively. You can do it on your own, but when you do it through the leading of the Holy Spirit, it makes a difference. Praise God. Praise God. Scripture says, the Father has sent me. Jesus said, the Father sent me, so I'm sending you. And that he breathed on them and said, receive this Holy Spirit. The Father sent him. The Father, he were one. Now he's breathing on us. He's giving you the Holy Spirit. Praise God. After he gives you the Holy Spirit, he's authorizing you to do the will of the Father. Praise God. Jesus was leaving earth physically, but promised that the Lord would be with him. And the Holy Spirit had to leave him. Praise God. Actually, he's given the apostles the keys to the kingdom. He said, boys, you got the keys. You got the keys. Whatever's bound on earth is bound in heaven. Whatever's loose on earth is loose in heaven. You can forgive folks because I'm telling you to go do that. And they did that. They preached the gospel. They shared the word. And a lot of them were crucified just like Jesus was. But they did what the master said, because he sent them to do what he said. So as I give it a close, let me prophesy to somebody this morning. When Jesus shows up in your room, your miracle just getting ready to take place. When Jesus shows up in your life, your miracle just getting ready to take place. You ought to testify. That's the last time I'm going to tell somebody. We tell somebody, when Jesus shows up in our life, my miracle getting ready to start happening. My miracle is getting ready to start happening. I'm thanking God for my miracle. I'm thanking God for my blessing. I'm thanking God what he's done for me, what he's going to do. When my miracles start just starting to happen right now, because I've already got the word of peace, already been breathed on with the Holy Spirit, and I have received the Holy Spirit. Now when Jesus shows up in my life, my miracle get ready to happen, my blessing just taking place. Praise God. I thank God for that. I give God glory for that in this place. When Jesus shows up in the room, your marriage will start taking, going better in your life. Your loved one things begin to go better in your life this morning. Your families all be reunited all over again. When Jesus shows up, praise God, your family will be united. Your children will no longer be on drugs. When Jesus shows up, alcohol will stop. When Jesus really shows up, the shooting of innocent lives will cease. When Jesus shows up, your job will be restored and refilled. When Jesus shows up, your real friends will return back to you. When Jesus really shows up, your finances will be blessed. When Jesus shows up, you will be prosperous and be in good health. And Ephesians 3:20 says, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you may ask or think, according to the power of the Holy Spirit that works in us. Let me give you one more time in case, because we said earlier, sometimes the more you hear it, begin to take birth in your heart. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you may ask or think, according to the power that works inside of us. Thank the Lord. He's able to work it out for your good. Now to him that's able. Now to him that's able to do all you want to do and even more. More your mind even think about today. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Somebody give God a thanksgiving of praise. Because when Jesus really shows up in your life, things will get better. I'm going to stand on his word. I will stand on his word. Having done all, I'm going to stand. Because when he shows up, Lord really shows up. He came in that room. Those guys were afraid. They were scared. But they had walked with him for 3 years. Look what they've done to Jesus. They could do the same thing to us. The first thing Jesus spoke, just be at peace. Let this peace be with you. Twice he said, just peace be unto you. Don't be worried. The enemy is going to rise up on every hand, but just not only I'm going to speak that word, but I'm going to blow breath into you for a new life. Your new life is coming. Your new life is coming. Thank God for that. Your life abundantly is coming. Your life abundantly is coming. Your life abundantly is coming. Then just receive the Holy Spirit. Just receive. You don't have to do what the world do to receive it. You just receive it. Receive the gift he's given to us. Just receive that gift he's given to us. Somebody today just need prayer. We're going to pray.
Praise God. Yes. Praise the Bell family. For Jonathan, son. Prayer needs. God is so awesome. He knows every one of them. He knows their name. He knows what they're going through, what they've been through. So, Father, in Jesus' name, for every name that's been called this morning, that situation is for surgeries is coming this week. Those that lost loved ones, those bodies racked with pain, situation, those in the hospital, out of the hospital, God, you know their situation, you know their condition. So, Lord, we just offer ourselves to you, Lord, to call upon your name. Help us, oh God, to speak peace to those situations. Help us, oh God, to speak peace in their conditions today. Breathe on them right where they are. Now in Jesus' name. Allow the Holy Spirit, God, to reign right in the room, in our atmosphere. Today in Jesus' name. For your goodness, for your mercy, your grace given to your children this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, dear God. Thank you, dear God. God, we glorify your name. Every family, God, that's going through right now, whether here or watching online, speak over that situation today to allow your Holy Spirit, God, to reign within our lives. In Jesus' name, we give you thanks, God. We give you glory and praise today in Jesus' name. We do pray. We pray with thanksgiving. We pray, thank you ahead of time, Lord. We thank you ahead of time, God, before they even realize they've been blessed, before they realize they've been healed, before they realize they already been receiving what we're asking for. So, Lord, we count it done today. In Jesus' name, we pray. Somebody shout amen and amen.
every name, every condition, every situation. We thank you and we praise you. Praise God. Minister Liz is coming to pray for our community as we break bread together.
So, Father God, we thank you again for this opportunity to break bread on today, God. Father, we thank you for your word, Lord God. We thank you for your blood that was shed for us. We thank you for your body, Lord God, that you gave for us, Lord God. Lord, we ask that you would bless this cup this morning, God. Lord, that you would turn it from a carnal use into a spiritual use on today, God. We pray for each and every person that will partake of it today, God, knowing that it was because of you that we're able to do this, Lord God. Lord, we just thank you, and we just praise you, and we glorify you for what we're about to do right now, God. Let your anointing be on it, God, that some might be healed today, some might be delivered today through the taking of the blood on today and the bread on today. God, we thank you. God, we praise you. For what can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make us whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. So God, we thank you for your blood. We thank you for your body on today. Lord, you said for us to do this in remembrance until you come. So we thank you and we praise you.
Yes,
and
God,
we receive this unto you today, God, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Have not received your communion, please raise your hand to be served. If anyone have not received yours, about the bread, which represents his body. that was given on Calvary just for us. Thank God he gave his life. They couldn't kill him, but he gave his life. He gave it for us, for you and for me. He knew our sinful ways, but he gave his life for us. None of his bones were broken, but he gave his life. As we break this bread, we're doing it unto him. Let us all eat together. Thank God for the blood. Represent to this communion cup at the Passover. He says, when I see the blood, I'll pass over. Thank God for the blood of the Lamb that washes away the sins of the world. Thank God that he shed his blood just for you and for me. Praise the Lord. Let's all drink together. Continue to pray for Sister Viola Hobson as well, Deacon Hobson's mom. Thanks again for Brother Greg Hobson coming today all the way from Lynchburg. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. But praise the Lord. The Bible said that night they sung a hymn and left there rejoicing, knew what the Lord had in plan for him to do. Be at peace with the Lord. May God's peace be with you. May God's breath blows through your life. And just continue to receive the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Thank you, thank you. Yeah. Yeah. Well,
came to really